By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to simulate 3D crack growth in Abaqus using XFEM method. We'll walk through the setup, step by step, geometry, mesh, damage setting, and critical options that make or break a successful crack simulation. Whether you failed before or you're trying this for the first time, this guide will get your crack growing reliably. And if you want to download the simulation files, just check out the pinned comment down below. Let's get started. Okay, as always. Always we start with a part, create a part, name it plate, because we're going to have two parts and it should be 3D deformable solid extrusion. Make this 400, continue. We need to create a rectangle just like this. This guy must be 100 and this one must be 200. Scroll button, done. And the depth can be 3. Okay, this is the plate we have. Now we're going to create the crack. So we name it crack 3D deformable shell extrusion. Continue. We just create a line just like this. Scroll button. And this should be 40 millimeters, so the crack we have is 40 millimeter, and the depth is 3 millimeters, the same. And here we have the parts. Now let's go to the property. In order to download the properties, let's go to the feamaster.com. okay, this is the feamaster.com. go to the shop and material property packs. Here we have aluminum XFEM added to the card. It's a free download, as you see. And then go to the checkout. After filling everything, you're able to download this file. And I'm opening it. Okay, this is the file we have. We can copy and paste everything. Let's jump back to Abaqus, create the materials properties. This is aluminum. We need Young's modulus, so let's create the mechanical, elasticity, and elastic. Copy this one and paste it here. Then we need to have mechanical, plasticity, and plastic, because it is aluminum, as we have the plasticity at the tip of the crack. So let's go here and copy and paste this values here. Then from mechanical, damage for traction separation laws, max PS damage, you need to put the maximum here. This is here 350, and we need to have damage evolution. Put this one on energy and copy this value, paste it here, and okay. And we're done with the properties. Now we need to create a section, solid, homogeneous, and continue. The material is aluminum, and we need to assign the section. We assign the section here, we uncheck this one, and done. Okay, as it turns green, it means the material is assigned. Okay, let's go to assembly. We assemble the model here. Let's put it on independent, select both, and okay. Now I want to translate this one from here to here, basically. Yep. And we need to move this one, so I select this one, put this one here to here, and as you see, we have the crack. The difference between this video and the previous one is that we should have the 3D crack. We cannot just have a wire or just a line. We should have a plate. Or sometimes we have semicircular cracks or round cracks. Okay, we're done with the assembly. Let's go to the step. Create a step. Step 1 initial, static general. Continue. Toggle on analgium. And here we should have like 1 million. 1e minus 2, 1e minus 9, oops, 1e minus 9 here, yeah. And 1 is okay here. Now we need to go to the field output manager. Here I need to go to the failure and fracture and go all the way down, toggle these two, and from state we should go to the status XFEM and toggle this on and okay in order to see the opening of the crack or the separation of the material. Now this is the step. Let's go to the interaction. Here we need to go to the special and from crack let's go to the create. Now select XFEM, continue, and you need to select the crack domain first. This is the crack domain or crack region, and we want to define the crack location. So select this one, edit, and maybe it's better to rotate to select the crack, and this is the crack, and done. As you see, it should turn magenta, and this is the crack, and the other part is the crack domain. And okay, now you would see all these X's, it means it is assigned. Now we need to create one other interaction from step initial, XFEM crack growth, continue, and we need to select the crack one. And okay, in this manner we allow the crack to grow. And this is the interaction. Let's go to the load from the boundary condition manager. We create the boundary conditions. First I need to create the symmetry or encaster, select everywhere, then hold control and deselect others. We only need the bottom part, and done. It should be encased, and done. Next we need to create another one from the displacement and rotation type. Now we need to select this part and hold control and deselect the other part, and as you see we only selected the top part, and done. It only can displace in the Y direction, so I leave it open and select others, and okay, and it should be propagated. And that is for the boundary condition. Now we need to create load. So from here, create load, step one should be pressure, continue, we rotate it a little, select this top part, and done. And it should be uniform, and as this is pressure we want to have the tension, so I put the minus sign here, and done. Here you see the arrows should face upward. And yeah, that's pretty much everything in the load. Let's go to the mesh. Let's make the mesh dependent. So from here, simply, so select these two and select make dependent. I made a mistake, sorry. And here we should go to the part, and this is the plate, and put this seed on 4, then okay, then this one, select yes. Now it's good, we don't need to mesh this part, so in the assembly it should look like this. Now we're good to go to the job. But before creating the job, I want to ask you a favor. If you enjoyed this video so far, please leave a comment for me down below. It's totally free for you, but it motivates me to create more videos like this. Thank you. Now create the job, name it XFEM crack growth 3D. That's a long name, but it's okay. Continue. Okay, now we need to submit the job, and it says some parts haven't assigned the sections, but that's okay. Click on yes and see how it goes. Now the job is running. Let's go to the monitor. And as you see, we don't have errors and the warnings are fine and the job is running, as you see. All right, now it's finished. As you see, it says completed. Let's go and take a look at the results. I put it on this. Let's switch the view. And as you see, we have a crack growth here. Let's put this one on option, common. And from here, we can have feature edges and put this one on OK. And you see here the crack growth and it is more visible in this view. We can have different options. For instance, let's see the animation first. I want to make it slow. The crack grew, yeah. Okay, this is the animation. And let's go see other things. File LSM. Let me reset the view. I put it here and make sure to put this one like the very final step. So I want to talk about what file LSM is. This is represent the sign distance function for the level set method used in XFEM. It defines how far a point is from the crack surface. Positive values indicate material away from the crack, while negative values indicate material inside the crack. When this is zero, it defines the actual crack surface. When it's greater than zero, the material that is intact and not cracked. While it's lower than zero, the material inside the crack fully separated. As you see here, we have the value of 1e-6, and as we go forward it would be 0.85 and the region is here. Let's go for the next one, PsyLSM, and I want to talk about this one also. So what is this one? This stands for principal level set distance field. It used to track the crack propagation direction in XFEM simulation. When this value is zero, it defines the crack surface and it determines the principal direction of the crack front. Let's see how it is in the beginning. As you see, we only have it here and the value of zero is here. And as we go forward, it propagates. And this is the zero here. And other things we can see here is the displacement. This is the amount of displacement and a status XFEM. We chose the enriched elements. One means fully cracked and zero means uncracked. So if we put this one, comment, on exterior edges, just like this. And if we zoom in, you see here, we only have this one. Then it opens up, and as you see here, we have values just close to one. It means the crack is propagating. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please smash the like and subscribe button to see more videos like this. And if you want to learn 3-point bending in Abaqus, click on the video on the screen before it ends. Stay tuned.